Hello, Monsters Abound here, and welcome back to Total War Warhammer 3 and part 16 of my Ku'gath Plague Father campaign, where last time we beat up the Wood Elves, took the jungles of Qiyan. Looks like the... Oh, hello.
I am a dragon!
Hang on. You've already got plague. You're fine. Alright, won't worry about you. Everyone's got plague. Everyone's got plague, even you've got plague. Is that the right plague? Yes, okay, good. Good. Everyone's got plague. We're mopping up. It's all good. We're going to have to kill these savage orcs. Apparently, they've already been fighting, but I don't know who. So, I mean, goods, I guess. Glad that is the case. Right, we've also got Croc. Croc now. They're getting a little bit feisty over here, so I'm tempted to move Croc in this direction. Something like that. Money is fine. I definitely don't feel like super duper rich. Actually, let's cancel you. I guess you? Something like that. I mean, I've got three... how many provinces do I have, just out of interest? I've got 12 provinces, 33 settlements owned, and 3 armies. So that's less than one army for every 10 settlements I own. And I'm making enough money to, like, kind of build up my economy if I'm lucky. Which doesn't necessarily feel great. I feel like at this point I should be significantly richer. That's all.
Cultist.
I just feel like I should be significantly richer. Anyway, so far, we're fairly secure on this front. I panicked when I saw this guy here for a second, but that's fine because he's just a caravan. He can't do anything. And Rapanz and Cetra don't like each other. However, they're not at war. Looks like Sartosa's doing okay for itself. Wurzag's doing okay for itself. Scarbrand has managed... Scarsnake, that's the one. It's managed to wipe out the dwarves, which is pretty impressive, not going to lie. Do you want to repair this? We don't have the money. Yeah, of course we don't have the money. Jungle to Qiyan, I'm going to go with this one. Going to go with this one. So, we need to wipe out Cathay. Squash Cathay. Expand our reach. Hello. A peace treaty. No, Zartan. Sorry, bud. Sorry. I might come and kill you afterwards, actually. I might head north. Actually get some Chaos Waste settlements. Which might help with, you know, the first tech that we get, which helps with Chaos Wastes. Which we don't start anywhere fucking... Right, what you are up to, I don't know. Can I just come... Come here. Come here, I want a chat. I want just a chat. Just a chat. Just a... I'm just going to resolve this, because... Fucking hell, elves.
Shield us.
Bring them. Fucking hate them. Okay, I'm going to... Right, we're going to leave Andrew, much like the Emperor left the Patriarchs to continue the Crusade. Because I've been listening to the Horus Heresy. And, fuck, that guy was fucking useless. Oh, Peasant Decay, yes. I will say, I do like the Horus Heresy for making the characters, you know, for making all of the Primarchs feel just kind of good. Like, they have some character, they've got some... Abaddon is still fucking boring, though. Jesus Christ. Even in the Horus Heresy, he's just so fucking boring. So tedious. Couldn't give a flying shit what happens to that guy. Now or ever. Okay, those guys are out of here. Excellent. I guess we could head this... You know what? I changed my mind. We're going to head this way, because Ku'gath is meandering. He's going to go that way. We're going to go this way. We're going to hit the Tower of Ashul, and then Dai Cheng. Sort this all out. looks all good. I probably want to upgrade this one. Get that one on the go. How many infections? Oh, we've got loads of infections. Oh my god, you've got 18 turns of plague. Holy shit snacks. How the fuck did that happen? How long does this plague last for? Okay, I actually shouldn't have done it there because there's no reason for it. No reason to plague that. Never mind. Not a big problem. We need like 16k so I can upgrade you in 2 turns. And then we might get more great unclean ones than the one that we had previously. Let's get rancid visitations because that's always good for taking out characters. I'm going to upgrade you. Change my mind. I'm going to upgrade you instead. So we can do that. Get those ones upgraded. How much money are we making here out of it? It's just under 2k. I mean, you know, it's fine. It's fine. There I go. Talk about saving money and then instantly spend all. You're gonna defensive alliance. Oh, no, I just don't trust you. I'm gonna squash you if I find you because you're gonna betray me. It's gonna happen. It's gonna happen. Nope, they're already dead. Oh, I should have taken that defensive alliance. Fuck. We got the money then. All right. Exiles of Khorne will come and assist. I don't think it's going to take up too much of their time, to be honest. And those guys are dead. Wow, lots of plague. It is what we want. Okay, let's go and plague these guys, because I'm trying to spread that plague. The fuck happened to Jade Wind Mountain? The fuck happened there?
Seek fresh experiments.
Okay, you've got plague. I'm just going to follow you around, to be honest, because I want to make sure that you stay plagued. I'm changing my mind all the time. Go to Taizhu. Oh, you've got Shangyang, haven't you?
I have bathed in lightning. I am energized.
Uh-huh. No, you're not going to give that to me, are you? Well, maybe I can take Taiju and then give it to you? Something like that? I don't know. We're going to save our pennies. Take Dai Cheng next, I think. Do we need plague anywhere? I mean, yes is the answer. Growth plague. Boff. There we go. 17 turns, 16 turns, 12 turns. You know what? You got to speculate to accumulate.
Wondrous day.
Indeed. I'm going to give you Wound Maker so you have 859 weapon strength. And then we're just going to not worry about this. Rolling up the mountains should be fairly easy. As long as we've got Ku'gath and Croc sort of like rolling north with us, we should act as like a dragnet. So any armies we come across should be, one, plagued, and two, fucking exterminated. Oh, well, shame for them. Rise of Visitations for all great unclean ones, which of course is going to be quite useful. Lots of plague. Jesus. Shit. Is that going to be a huge problem for us? I mean, yes, but okay, where are they going to come from? They're going to be here, aren't they? And here, and basically all along the mountains. Okay, well, we can still work with that, but we're going to have to push this. Cathay needs to die like about 10 turns ago. Changing our route. How long have you got? 1 turn? Right, I'm going to plague you again. No, it's not fair, but, you know, there we go. Interesting. Apparently you can't refresh Plague. You just gotta wait until it ends. Good to know. It's nice that that information is obvious, delivered to the player. Fuck's sake. Right.
Cultist of the Fly Lord.
That's Miao Ying. I am no one's servant. Never said you were, madam. Never said you were. Right, is there any tech here that I really need? Saws would give us that saws thingamajig, which is fine. Armor, I don't really care about. Weapon strength for rot flies. That only affects rot flies, not the plague drones. I guess magic item drop chance isn't the worst thing. Income from post-battle loot and magic item drop chance. It's basically everything I want all rolled up into one. Fantastic. Okay, still saving up pennies. Saving up pennies so that we have enough to build the upgrades. Because we need not quite 16k. I think we need about 15,500 or something like that. Ooh, Grimgor's finally knocked them out. That's impressive, considering just how strong those guys usually are. So, good job, Grimgor. You're quite a big tanky boy. Right, we do have to be careful of the fact that the dwarves are about to go apeshit. So we're heading north. Where's Shet? There he is. Okay, let's hit you with a plague. Yep, no replenishment for you, my friends.
I obey.
Or you.
A pox to cripple.
Excellent. Okay, we need to pick up the pace. Pick up the pace.
I bring the plague if.
I mean, with any luck, maybe the dwarves won't be too bad. Oh, I do need the income. I do need the income.
Pulverize them.
Need the cash.
The joy of disease.
Boop, boop, boop.
The fly master.
Okay, Andrew, I'm going to give you blade shit. No. Scarred veteran.
A delightful addition to my arsenal.
You get that one. We're moving up, moving up, moving up. Go and take Xing. We need to squeeze Cathay to death. It looks like Kolek. I've never seen Kolek do well. He normally gets like stomped out by Archaon. What are you doing? Your strength rank 74. Seriously, shit me. Jesus. Let's have a look at strength ranks. Nagron's 2. That could be useful for when your friend turns up. Ironbar is 3. That's bad news. If he's strength rank 3 already. Grimgor's at 4. That's impressive. Good job there. Sylvania at 5. Pamictus at 6. Ghosts of at 7. Apparently they've taken the entire Chaos Wastes. Yep, good stuff. Orion's at 9. Anorapants at 10. Although, Scarstick at 11 there. Not doing too badly for himself. Not doing too badly for himself. Cathay, though, losing ground, being forced back across whatever the fuck river this is. The Celestial Lake? It's the Jade River. Being forced back across the Jade River. We control everything, well, most things south of it. And the Serpent River. There's the Serpent River and the Jade River. And we control everything. So, yeah. You don't need to eliminate it. It's fine. Also, I need more plague. Plague are you? Oh, you're called the Growth Plague. Holy shit, you spread far. Holy shit. Okay, good. I don't necessarily need to worry about you too much. Oh, do I upgrade this one? Do I upgrade this one? Yes. No. No, I want to hold Minerve. 14,800. Okay. Well, we can do that next turn. When do you finish? 7 turns? Okay. Well, tell you what, let's... Okay. Seeing as that's going to take a little while, let's upgrade you. Let's upgrade you. Good. We're gonna save everything else. The thing is, once we've dealt with Cathay, this region should be fairly safe, so we can then start building this up. Although, frankly, having enough money to upgrade all of these buildings is... I genuinely cannot imagine how much money that's going to actively take. And obviously it'll generate... I think the... Coming back into it again, it's the problem that each Nurgle building produces a minimal amount of income, which means that you need all of the buildings in the province to make the same amount of money as you could from literally just having, like, a tier 3 building in pretty much any other faction. I think that's the problem. More plague? Not as much plague as I was hoping, but never mind. Okay. Miao Ying, hold up in this little settlement here. What is it, a settlement battle? Is this a capital? Any day now? There we go, it is a capital. That's fine. We'll just have to smash the door in and kill everyone inside. Big boys leading the way. Bladebearer's behind. We're attacking the actual wall rather than the little canyon here. I like how the AI deployed, thinking that I probably would. Yes, it does have my number. I was really tempted, but I decided not to. Oh, careful. Bring in the flyer boys in. Use them to harass and tie up those missile units, particularly the cannons, taking out the grand cannons. Taking a little bit of fire there. And doing very little in return until we knock down the... Until we knock down the walls. Anyway, get gates. Gates, knock down the gates. Well, we've got some archers, crossbows on the bridge. They're about to learn why it's a bad idea to sit on the bridge. That's right, because you get thrown off it. A little light boil there. Ooh, ripping through the crossbows and the iron hail gunners, basically taking them out of action. And we're just throwing people all over the bridge here. Getting thrown to their death. Down they go. So far, so good. And I mean, okay, they do have crossbows, halberds. I do have the halberds, which obviously not great for the plague drones, but we'll have reinforcements inside the city momentarily. Guys, you gonna knock down the gate, or are you having a breather? Oh, they've opened. Oh, for fuck's sake! All right, the gate's down. We're getting in the mix. J-Boy has been thrown around and we're inside the city. The Plague Bearers will be backing us up momentarily. There are a few units that have managed to join up over the other side of the bridge. I don't particularly want to travel over the bridge, to be honest. I could potentially park my Plague Bearers on there and just launch Death Heads off below. But by the time I get everyone over there, they'll probably have fucked off. Okay, the plague drones. Great unclean ones. The cultist, Adidas and Reebok. Of course, Bilious Thunderguff. Just drawing up and preparing to push further into the city. The plan is we're going to push up over here and then onto the city centre. I mean, technically that's the city centre, but pretty much by the time you reach here, the battle's over anyway. Plague drones helping to just mop up any units on this side. Of course, they do have missile attacks. And then I've only got 9 ammunition, which is not very much. I think it's 10 ammunition, actually. But either way, they won't do a huge amount of damage. But they can certainly attack units from above, particularly things like halbards. A few units still meandering around this side, getting blasted by Kugath's artillery fire. The plague bearers. The plague bearers draw up into their lines. We're now pushing up. We've got a couple of units of crossbows. And the unit of Jade Warriors, as well as a cannon that's currently heading this direction, although it's been wandering backwards and forwards, so it's anyone's guess. Miao Ying is just sitting around. She's making her way up to the city centre. There we go. Plague drones forming up over the other side of the under road there. And our plague bearers moving up to throw their death heads at these crossbows. Yep, that's pretty devastating. They did not like that. Understandably, really. Wanna go again? Another little. I think they're going to have enough and flee. Meanwhile, Reebok trying to smash his way through the barricades, sending more death heads in this general sort of direction. The plague drones managed to catch a couple of archers and crossbows who are trying to get across the bridge. And now they won't. And looking at numbers here, we've killed 1,000 of them and lost 4 guys in return. I think we have the upper hand. So the great unclean one. Uncle Fanuncle. I forgot about him. He's down here. I forgot Uncle Fanuncle and Cuddles. I left them down here without thinking about it. I wish the Beast of Nurgle had like more members in its unit. Just the one guy just seems a little bit meh. Had like a little unit of 4 or something. Be like, yeah, that's fine. Just the one. It's just not effective. It's kind of useful for the debuff, and that's about it. Jade Lancers getting absolutely annihilated. And there's very little to stop our advance. Just need to mop up these archers. And also not forget that Cuddles and Uncle Fanuncle are down there. It's fine. They will they'll come into play later. Meanwhile, it's just a case of pushing on. We've got some more crossbows in the way. God, they're even trying to get some shots off. Very brave of them. Doing great. Yeah, that unit's disintegrated almost immediately. Miao Ying realizing that she's going to have to throw herself into combat to slow her advance. I mean, she's quite a killy lady. Let's be honest here. Plus, I think she's got stalk. No, is it stalk? Is it hide stalk? I think she's got stalk because she probably killed Clan Eshin. Because obviously they start in Cathay, and I haven't seen a hide nor a hair of them, so I'm guessing they just died really quickly. Miao Ying going dragon form there. And popping all of her abilities by the looks of it. Eye of the Storm, Charm Shield, giving us some resistance there. We've suddenly realised that Uncle Fununcle is needed. I mean, Cuddles is fine. That'd be alright. Bringing Kugath up to help. We have several units of spears and ooh, even some Celestial Dragon Guard throwing themselves into the melee. These guys, you know, good weapon strength, good melee attack, excellent melee defense, and also armor. And I also have charge reflection. So Miao Ying is actually not doing so hot there. She's trying to get out of that fight. Looks like she is going to get away. We are going to hit her with a Rancid Visitation as she flees. I don't think that's going to kill her, but it will leave her on very low health. So we do have quite a number of Celestial Dragon Guards and Peasant Long Spearmen. So I figured, well, why not just hit them with as many Blight Boils as we can and see what happens? Yeah, that was pretty effective. That's kind of cleaned the boards. The Celestial Dragon Guards absolutely eviscerated. They're now fleeing in terror. And we're just flooding into the city centre. There's nothing left to stop us. There's some Jade Warriors and some archers hanging around. But to be honest, it's a little bit too little too late. Here comes the Plague Drones flying overhead, bombarding the enemy as they go and picking targets wherever they can. Plague Bearers swarming into the city. And the defenders realize it's hopeless and flee the battlefields. Once again, Miao Ying gets her ass kicked. And I'll take the sacking income and I will occupy. Because God knows I need the cash. Oh, you would be in there, you piece of shit. Well, I want, if we lay siege to you, I mean, what you gonna do? Realistically. Kill me, apparently. We're just gonna leave you in there, basically. I'm just gonna hold you in. While we continue on our rampage. So we got three sets, so we can just sort of go bop, 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 bop. At that point, we're sort of near where Kugath. Kugath can sort of like run around here, grab all these settlements in the mountains. I don't know why these are ruins. Skaven? There's no Skaven corruption here, which suggests not. Maybe they never resettled them? I don't know. Okay, you got two more skill points to go. If that was like faction wide, oh, you've got 46 ammunition. You never run out of ammunition. That's never going to be a problem. Maybe magical reserves. Little bit of extra winds of magic. Can go amiss. I'm just going to tick you. I think you're fine. Okay, as soon as we've got lots of money, let's upgrade all this. See if we can make that into a... yes, we'll upgrade you as well. You are four turns away, but we're making 7,000. That's probably going to be fine. I think what we need to do is be... The thing is, I just don't think you can make any kind of garrison with Nurgle where it's not just going to be kind of shit. Okay, let's just repair you. And we'll leave it at that for the moment. We've still got 10k to play with. You know what, let's upgrade some bits. Let's upgrade some bits. We can do that. Yes, because this is quite good, because we do have a lot of trade goods here. So obviously that's going to boost up the income. Also, it's already a level 4, so, I mean, that's pretty good. If we can get the Lesser Garden of Blight... She brings in 700 at max, which is really good. Well, it's really good, apart from when you know... I think all the cycles should be shortened, maybe. Like, the number of nodes should be equal across all cycles. Like, every normal military building should have 5. Every advance should have 7 or something. Maybe they should also have 5. Something like that. It's just really hard to determine. With most factions, you can go, okay, I understand that if I get... You know, if I build this building, it'll give me a flat income. If I build this building, it'll give me a percentage increase. Something like that. With Nurgle, you just kind of go, I don't know what the fuck's going on. The vast majority of the time. You are quite beaten up. You do have... Sky Lanterns aren't necessarily an issue. If we can take out the artillery. Okay, sure, why not? Okay, tough battle. Well, we'll do it. It's fine. Got our doggos running in from behind. We need to take out those artillery units. Doesn't really help that for some reason my units are running all over the fucking place. Look at these guys. Where the fuck are you going? I know you're coming back. I'm fairly sure it's some pathing shenanigans. Basically, that does really not help me. Okay, the doggos swooping in from behind. We have managed to dodge most of the enemy units. Tell you what, these halberdiers are a pain in the fucking ass. Also, we've got Zhao Ming to kill, who is... He will not go down easily. I'm trying to get my death heads thrown. Let's get some death heads in there, lads. You see the doggos coming in from behind. That's it. Tearing through the enemy artillery. And also eating the bottoms of those Jade Warriors. Although we are taking damage in return. So the main issue is we don't really have an answer for Zhao Ming. I mean, apart from trying to hit him with Rancid Visitations, but he does have regeneration. Peasant archers, on the other hand, are easy targets. I should replace these Nurglings with something better. Like Chaos Knights or something. Anything, really. Doesn't matter. It's fine. Xiao being a pain. So he's just regenerating at this point. What's this do? He's got the seed. Oh, he's got the Seed of Rebirth. Oh, fuck. Well, no wonder he's regenerating so quickly. Ooh, nice shots there, Death Heads. Doing good work. The Pox Riders. I do not want to get the Pox... The Pox Riders do not do very well against Halberdiers. Let's put it that way. They will get their ass handed to them by Halberdiers. Not even close. And while we've got the Marauders... Trying to hack their way through the Jade Warriors. So those Halberdiers are just a nightmare to cut through. Oh, Croc's not doing very well. He's surrounded by Oh, Celestial Dragon Guardian. No wonder he's getting his ass handed to him. Okay, the battle is so far going not our way, the opposite way. Right, the Box Riders having run down some Jade Warriors. Doggo's coming back for another go. See if we can get them in amongst those archers. Take him apart. We also have, of course, our Chosen. I do like the mods that has made these Chaos Warriors look a little bit more Nurgle. I really like that. I think it's a shame that CA didn't do that. Because I feel like, you know, considering the modders have done it, it can't have been that hard. And it looks really effective. Like, I look at that and I go, yes, that looks really good. Genuinely. And it's just reusing body parts from other units. But it just works, right? Just do it with other units as well. Why not? You know, let's get Zinch Boys. Let's get some weird oddities in there. It's just, you know, make each Chaos Warrior look unique. If they are Slaanesh Chaos Warriors, let's make them look Slaanesh. Let's give them some arseless chaps, some nipple rings. You know, give the people what they want. Arseless chap, Chaos Warriors. Did I say Space Marines? I might have said Space Marines. I don't know. I've been listening to the Horus Heresy quite a bit. So, I'm on that bullshit at the moment. It's like 64 books, though. 64 books! I'm listening to it on Audible. Each book's like 10 hours long. I don't know if I'll live that long, guys. Okay, Zhao Ming continuing to be a massive pain in the ass. The hippity hops, hippity hopping. Okay, the doggo's coming back yet again. Croc down to just. The problem is, all of these fucking Sky Lanterns are just continually, like, chipping away at him. And there's absolutely nothing I can do. I don't have anything to attack them with. I've got no cover. So I'm just having to try and dodge the shots. And hope for the best. It's kind of a pain in the ass. Xiao Ming almost back up to full health. That's not good. That's very bad. Not to mention this army is going to be significantly harder to rout with Zhao Ming still alive. That said, it's on a knife edge. I mean, even if we lose this battle, Zhao Ming still got plague, right? So he ain't replenishing. Uh-oh. Croc, no, get out of there, Croc, get out of there, buds, get out of there, Croc, get 120, Croc, run, get out of there, 57 hit points, that's not enough, run, into the trees, into the fucking trees, you're fine, you're okay, get into the trees, no, oh, he did not get into the trees, okay, well, you know, some people may celebrate the death of Croc, but oh, these rice paddies are not going to be any good for anyone. Probably ever again. Okay, Zhao Ming is continuing to be a massive pain in the ass. We have managed to break their flank. I mean, even if Zhao Ming wins this, it's going to be a Pyrrhic victory. Most of his units are dead. They won't be replenishing anytime soon. And I can just recruit units out of my ass. You know what? The hippity hops, the box riders, are actually doing a lot better than I thought they would do. I thought they would just disintegrate. But look, they've got 143 kills. They're actually doing very well for themselves. Fair play, guys. I feel like maybe Chaos Knights would probably just be better. I mean, they're faster, probably more heavily armored. I just generally think that if you want a fast moving unit for Nurgle, just get the Chaos Knights. They're probably just better. Xiaoming, okay, he has capped out on his health. He has capped out. Looking at numbers. Well, I mean, he certainly has lost a lot of guys. However, with our general dead, that is going to... That is going to push the battle in the enemy's favour. I think our Chosen are still doing quite well. Yeah, the Chosen are just tanking everything. I think the only issue is Xiaoming, who, again, we don't really have an answer for. We've got... And these guys got 155 kills. That's not bad. The Exalted Plague Bearers, 133 kills. Again, they just have that, you know, chonky weapon strength there. Excellent melee defense. Good melee attack. They're just overall good. Not to mention the ward save, physical resistance, missile resistance as well. It's just super helpful. I think if we had something to take out Xiaoming, if we had some plague drones or something we could use to take out Xiaoming, I think this would be in the bag. But Xiaoming just in the center there, just holding what's left of his army together. I mean, the Chaos War Shrine has been doing fantastic work. It's healing up everyone, just keeping our army in the fight there, but there's now concentrated missile fire. I should have kept the doggos on side to just mop up all of these archer units. Unfortunately, the Chaos War Shrine is slowly taking damage, but it has... Yeah, it's such a good... You just chuck it in the middle of your army, and it will just help you hold the line. These halberdiers are just fucking and just a nightmare to deal with. Like, backed up by Xiaoming's leadership, they just don't break. And if they don't break, they're very hard to kill. Looks like we've got some routers. The Chosen are terrified. The Chaos War Shrine is retreating. Our demon units are starting to disintegrate. I think this battle's a loss. We've lost Croc as well. Not ideal. But our losses can be replaced. And Xiaoming's, well, yeah, they can't. Hot damn! Should have auto-resolved. Oh, it's those fucking halberdiers. They just don't fucking die. Celestial Dragon Guard are really hard to... The Halberdiers and the Celestial Dragon Guard are really hard to kill unless you've got missile weapons or like really good infantry or AoEs. I didn't really have any of that. Plus, taking out Xiaoming is, you know, he is quite a tanky boy. Plus, Croc's army was not exactly the greatest. I should probably get some better army. Well, get a new Croc. One with an untwistable plastic shoe. What do you got? You've got a Chaos Familiar. That's alright. Iron Skin. Don't really care about that. You've got Dark Fury. Don't really care about that. You've got a Burning Body. Yeah, I'm gonna get you. Well, poor old Croc. Oh, Ascendant. Good for us. Poor old Croc. Well, at least Xiaoming still has attrition. So he's not replenishing. He's just suffering more attrition. Let's get... Let's get some more lads. I mean, we want to keep, like, hitting them, right? Don't give them time to replace their losses. You know what? I will sack this. And then I will occupy it. Excellent. Okay, that will let me get some... Do I want some Chaos Spore? Let's do that.
Such potency.
New. Wait, no. New crop. There we go. We'll sort that out. Right. Xiao Ming's army is fucked anyway. And if we can just take out the Celestial Monastery and Village of the Moon people. Moon. Just. That's Village of the Moon. Not Moon people. Bloody Moon people. Right, we'll head north, we'll clean up all this, that'll give us the, hopefully, the resources we need to then take on the mother-chuffing dwarves when they return. But I'll have to wait until next time. Thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you in the next episode.